Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to All In Conversations. Today we have Lefty Holman and Dawson Hay, both NFR qualified cowboys. We hope you guys enjoy the show. Make sure you guys hit that like button, subscribe, and the notification bell so you guys know when our podcasts are live. All right, thank you for joining us. Enjoy the show.
They say that, I don't know if this is true or not, but they say that Calgary breeds their horses to have a shorter back. That way, whenever they kick, they don't mess anything up in their back. That's just kind of a rumor I heard, but I don't know if that's true. But that's getting to the genetics and everything. But
yeah, it's a little over my head. But
too.
I know I don't know if there's another contractor in the world that has put in more effort into their breeding program.
Yeah. Speaking of Calgary, while we got it, Dawson's broke the world record, tied the world record on the Calgary Horse Wild Cherry in Canada.
Yeah, no, that horse had dusted me the last two times. Yeah. I got on him, but it was just a, what do we got going on here?
This is the Rodeo Calgary.
Oh, this is the Rodeo Calgary. Yeah, no, just a really awesome horse. Got on him at Houston for the first time, and I missed her out and got bucked off, and then got to get on her at the Canadian finals that year and got her marked out and still fell off. So it's just one of them horses. It's a real heartbreaker. I think everyone's got a heartbreak story from Wild Cherry.
Yeah, they do.
Rusty at the NFR that one year, that was tough to watch.
Yeah. I can't wait to get on that one.
Yeah, you kind of dodged around that sucker.
I know. I've drawn around that horse quite a bit, but I'm looking forward to the data. See my name next to hers.
I think you'd do well on that sucker. That one, that Xena Warrior, that's an awesome horse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think Ming's getting that video pulled up over here. How did that feel to get off and know you just tied the world record?
Man, I don't even know if it sunk in for 2-3 weeks. It was, it didn't really sink in that I'd even stayed on for a second. I said I'd never throw my hat in my career. I told my dad that when I was younger, and I was like, I'm not going to do it. And then I got off, and it was just in the, like, worst throw ever, right in the crowd. Yeah. And then I'm standing there, and they're like 95 points, and I'm like looking for my hat.
Before we watch this video, how did you get your hat back?
I was, this kid was holding on to it, and then this dad or someone just snatched it out of his hands, and he comes running up to the gate, got like a high five from this other guy, and I'm like looking around, and it felt like it was like 5 minutes before I got my hat back, but yeah, no, gotta give it back. You got a story about losing your hat too.
Huh? Yeah, I do. I got a good one.
Was that the only time you've thrown it too?
Yeah, let's watch this video, then we'll pull mine up too, because I got a pretty funny one. This was a great spur out too.
Yeah, no, that's kind of the trick on that horse, is getting her spurred out.
Look how much rain he has.
Yeah, that second jump, she yanked about a foot of it from my
Adios hat.
There she goes. And
fractured his hand, pounding his chest.
Too. Broken collarbone, ribs, the whole lot. Straight to sports med.
No, that was a great ride.
No, that's an awesome event. Pollockville, have you got to make it up there
never
yet?
Never made it up there yet.
It's the biggest bronc match in Canada. Calgary's, I think it's the only bronc match that Calgary brings horses to. And watching some of them trips out that day with like Zeke and that explosive Skies world champion horse, mm-hmm. at Calgary Stampede, bareback horse.
Yes,
and to have it in the bronc riding was insane.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And to see the set of balls Zeke had on him when he walked up, and he was like first guy back, walks up and picks the bare back of the pen.
That's Zeke,
that's
man.
Pretty cool.
Zeke will do that. He'll always pick a bucker. You can always count on him doing that.
I know. I think he's got a crush on JB Mooney or something. Eh?
Yeah. Can you pull up the Reno ride? My Reno ride 2019.
2019?
Yep. Reno Rodeo. That was actually a pretty funny. I actually threw my hat when I was still on. I threw it so hard I fell off like 2 seconds after the whistle. But yeah. I threw it, so I don't know if the flight or the aerodynamics of my hat, it just took flight, and it flew probably 15 yards into the stand, and a very nice lady caught it, and I was so embarrassed to walk back and get my hat. You'll see it right here. It just takes flight. Oh.
Yeah, they probably chopped that out of there, eh?
No, oh, it's coming. Here it is. It's a cool toddy, a flying five. It's a great horse.
Oh, you've been on cool toddy too, huh?
No, I haven't. I've dropped. My dad's been on cool toddy, which is crazy.
Here it is, everyone.
Oh,
it's
nice. Gone. Oh, good jump off.
It's actually pretty funny.
That is pretty funny.
I was so embarrassed to get it right after the rodeo. Before my interviews, I had to go get my hat back from this.
I'm surprised you didn't pull like one of them, that longest ride clip where he just walks up the fence and says, keep it. I feel like that's a Lefty thing to do.
Yeah.
Little wink.
Yeah.
That's a way to win fans.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's good. Right there.
There
like
it goes.
A frisbee. Hey?
Fell right off.
That's funny.
Yeah,
that's from back in the archives.
Mm-hmm, that was
that's your first like big rodeo or big PRCA win.
It was, yeah, it was my biggest win yet for sure.
Cool set of spurs they give there, don't mm-hmm. they?
Got them hanging in my kitchen. Yeah, nice. they're cool. But isn't that the best feeling ever? That just reminded me of whenever you're walking back to the chutes and slapping all your buddies' hands.
Oh yeah.
Oh man, you can't.
No, it's hard to beat that.
It's hard to beat that feeling. That's a pretty awesome feeling.
No, absolutely. I mean, we're in a pretty cool sport where all your buddies are kind of, they're all rooting for you. And the ones that aren't, you probably aren't your buddies. So.
Yeah. Yeah, that's very true.
No.
So, like, with the NFR coming up, Dawson, what kind of preparations do you have towards it? Like, are you, what's your mental and your practice game? I know you went back home.
I come here to do a podcast. That's one of them. I've been just kind of trying to keep my mind straight. Just, you know, have confidence going into the finals this year. I'm not near as nervous going in, knowing like I've already been over there. I kind of got the ice broke over there my first year. Had a bit of success, but I'd like a lot more to come out of this year. I don't know. I'm going to get on some practice horses. I got on some back at home. And aside from that, just, I think a lot of the sport is being mentally sharp and confident. So I'm just going to go in there, get on like I'm getting on at the practice pen you see here in this video and try and stick to the basics.
So, I know you guys get to choose your broncs. When do you guys choose your broncs that you guys want at the NFR?
They usually choose
them. Like Lefty was in on the call. Mm-hmm. The top 20 in the world sit down and bust through. I think it starts out at 160 horses. And then they chop them down by like 30, another 30. And then you kind of get your final number. And there's three different calls. So all the horses are already set. A lot of them obviously been there before. Lots of times, and there's quite a few new ones in there this year. Mm-hmm. Guy hasn't seen before, but this year there was a ton of horses coming up like that kind of like huge rides got made on a lot of horses. Mm-hmm. This year that we'd never seen before.
Rodeo's growing, man.
Rodeo's growing.
It is.
That's for sure.
So for the eliminator pin, do you guys choose that or they choose it?
No, we pick all the eliminators. It's pretty crazy. The last year in 2019 I was there, it was the E-pen, and then there's like a semi-E-pen, which is kind of the E-pen's more just the really hard to ride buggers. Mm-hmm. I mean, lots of times there's not a bunch of huge scores in the E-pen. Mm-hmm. But then the semi-E-pen kind of moves towards the buckers that really maybe a little more flashy. But in 2019, there was a pin, I think, where out of the 15 guys, only five stayed on and one where six stayed on. Mm-hmm. It's crazy. So just shows the horsepower these days.
Yeah, they're definitely, the horsepower's there.
The horsepower's there.
Horsepower's there. If you go through that E-pin, it's a pretty scary list.
It's kind of, yeah, it's kind of like you're sitting there picking the horse, and you're like, really, dude?
But then when you look at it, you know, those calls are 4 hours, each one's 4 or 5 hours oh, yeah. long. You know, those guys go through each horse, dissect each one of them. And they're even, you know.
Oh, the best. It does get carefully looked over. Huh?
Oh,
very carefully.
Yeah,
very carefully.
But the E-pen's my favorite round, especially watching like the years that I wasn't there and watching my dad and stuff. Like, that's what sells the tickets is them E-penners. Mm-hmm. Like, and we're not shy to pick some pretty nasty stuff in there. Like, some guys get wiped out in the E-pen.
Mm-hmm.
Go back for sure. to how about San Antonio this year? So they have a bracket system, and if you make the semifinals and not the finals, I believe, then you go into the wild card. Yeah, right,
that's right.
and they put some nasty shit in there this year. Yeah. they had how many guys get to the wild card? Was it, is it 10?
10. 10.
Oh, 10 guys.
11 of them, and they only take one guy to the short round.
Yeah, and what was there? There's a broken leg this year.
One guy to the short round, so he automatically wins if he makes it.
Well, no, he just gets to go in because they take the top four from each semifinals, mm-hmm. and then I think they take two out of those.
I think you're right, yeah.
Out of the wild card round. But the wild card round, like, I mean, you're going against 10 or 12 guys, and obviously you're getting on, and it's some pretty sketchy stuff in there. This year scary. I wish there was a video of it. I should have sent it to Ming before we started here. Alan Bohr on that weekend, or yesterday's delivery. He got knocked.
Is that the one where he flew over the fence?
He got knocked out. Cole Ashbacker broke his leg. Mm-hmm. Jacob Kramer drug around the arena and got every spot of him stepped on. Yeah. Ben broke his saddle.
Yeah. Ming, you should look up the video of Zeke at San Antonio this year.
Oh, yeah.
Zeke in San Antonio, that'd be up.
It's funny. I could drop it. No, that was 2 years ago.
Oh, was that 2 years ago?
Yeah, I should pull that up. That's pretty funny.
Maybe on the next episode. But that just shows how them horses are in that pen. You know, there's some...
Oh, yeah. That judge even got wrecked out. Remember Wonchuk ran over the judge?
Yeah. Wonchuk's had a lot of times where he even got ran over last year. Remember at somewhere in Montana?
No, that was this last summer in Prineville, Oregon.
Prineville, Oregon, and pickup man ran him over.
Sorry if I'm talking over you. I'm new to this. No, but they had a committee judge. I don't even know if he was meant to. I don't even know if he was meant to be in there. And he was running over judges. He got Wonchuk really bad. And they fired him this year, but I guess he'd just been there for like 10 years and they kept bringing him back. He ran a horse over, like just plowed him over. Hello to that guy if he's listening.
To that guy out there.
Hey, so I mean, are there any broncs that you're scared of though, Dawson, going into the NFR?
I'm not particularly scared of any broncs. I don't think there's some you're definitely more worried about getting on. Like some, I'm more worried about horses leaving bad or rougher in the chutes. Once it's out there, like, it's not real scary getting on a eliminator because usually they buck you off 10 yards away from them and you land fairly decent. But I would say, I'm trying to pick. You know,
I get more scared to lose.
Lose.
I get more scared. If I have a great horse like this one here, I'd be more scared to lose than I would be to get on one. You know, I hate losing. Dawson's the same way. But whenever I have the best horse in the pen, I'll get nervous to mess him up and not win. Yeah. Is when I get nervous. But if you have a big, strong eliminator, let's throw Miss Ellie out there, Frontier, one of the strongest horses in the PRCA. I got on her in the, I think the third round at the NFR last year. And I wasn't scared to get on her because I knew how strong she was. You know, she throws everybody off. But one, like, let's say Flirtatious in the first round, I knew it was the best horse in there.
Yeah.
I was scared to lose on her, you know.
Yeah, it's almost like I think they're starting with the eliminator pen this year at the NFR, and I'm actually fine with that. I mean, you go lay it all out there in the first round instead of starting with like the hopper pen where everyone's waiting. Nobody's been on for a long, well, practicing a little bit, but as far as rodeoing, we haven't been rodeoing for a month at least, and to roll off a hopper in the first pen would almost be worse.
Yeah. Here's a video of Zeke at
Oh yeah,
it's not that one, D39.
No. It's on Stroke and Tony. I might be a little scared getting on that sucker.
No.
But I'd say yesterday's delivery, she's got me twice now, and in 2019 in the second round, smoked my head off her ass. She pitched so hard.
I remember that. That's a bucking sucker right there.
Yeah, no,
It's not you.
Can you pull up Instagram videos on there?
Yeah, I can pull up Instagram.
It's on Zeke's Instagram.
Oh, is it?
Okay. Yeah, it was this when everyone was doing like.
Here's yesterday's delivery.
Oh yeah, there she is right there. This was one of the best rides I'd ever seen. She's just a handful.
She turns, huh? She
just, oh, yeah.
She just switches strides.
Switches leads.
She just really never has.
And that spur out, so good. It's hard to spur out, I imagine.
No, it's actually, that's like,
really?
You'd think. That's the hardest part because
dang, 93.
She hits out of there and feels so good. You want to kind of hold him for that second jump. And then she really shoots forward and she like wrings your neck off, like kind of like that.
That was a bronc ride right there.
Yeah. No, it's, yeah, that's a really good horse.
That was a good bronc ride.
Dang, his head, dude, he's right there. Oh, man, he's like Stetson seeing. He's seen stars with that, too. Mm-hmm. Whiplashes like that, dude, that's got to really take a toll on your guys' neck, huh? You guys need to do it some does, neck exercises.
It gets all
man.
Tight. It almost makes it feel like you have a sore throat when you lose your chin that bad. Yeah. It like rips them muscles out of your throat,
and then it seems like the whole next week getting on, even if you get on a hopper, you're still losing your getting your chin pop. I don't know,
it kind of takes the strength out of your neck.
Yeah, it does. It's like your body just naturally shuts those muscles off or something, because I remember after Virgil I kind of had that, and then I had to get on Pinto Pass the next week. And then Pinto Pass was getting my chin.
you're kind of style though that you ride. You don't lose your chin as much as a lot of guys. You kind of have a shorter upper body build, and just the way you ride with your chin tucked and more more back. I don't know. I've always struggled with it.
I know if one gets my chin, it's usually not going very well, because not a lot of horses get my chin.
Usually a guy loses his chin when he's behind a little bit, mm-hmm. or your feet hang.
Yeah.
But yeah, so
you guys just got to direct me to which one. I mean, it's probably an old video.
Oh yeah, it's I'd have to. It's from San Antonio. You'd say he posts so much. It would have been like this.
Yeah, you guys need to post as much as Zeke is posting, man.
Yeah, go up. Right there.
Right there. There it is.
This one right here.
Yep.
This one's a classic. Right
here? Okay, give me a sec while I set that up for everybody. All right.
This was crazy. I want it in person. It was even crazier.
He loses his rein here about like the fifth jump or something. Right.
That's here. Not a fun one right there.
I don't know
how he stayed on.
He's just like, dang, he's getting jerked. Huh?
There's only one guy. Play that again. There's only one guy, I think, in the world that could stay on that long with no rein, especially on a horse of that caliber.
And it's like Zeke Thurston.
He hates hitting the ground. I travel with Zeke, and like, I don't know if there's anyone in the world. He will take the ground, but he will.
Oh man,
fight his ass off before he hits the ground. It don't matter if he's got to grab his swells, his cannel, or whatever. But it's pretty funny. It's a funny story about Zeke. He, so, you know, during the NFR, I don't know if you've rode at it before, but the first night they have that bucking horse sale that
everyone gets. Oh, yeah, I rode one time at that deal.
No, you did?
Yeah, I did.
I thought you said he was riding at it. No, Jake Finley got on at it, I think it was 2017, and he, like, lost his rein the first or second jump and then was trying to grab it and then got bucked off, and Zeke was sitting there kind of being witty, and he's like, you know you gotta hold on to that thing, right? And like, it's just being Zeke, kind of, you know, he's mm-hmm. a smart ass.
Yeah.
That night he has that best hope of that horse out in Florida. Mm-hmm. You know that big
I've been on that horse.
He goes out, loses his rein, and gets like backdoored that night of the finals.
Oh gosh.
I was there watching.
It's actually funny. Jake Finley commented on this post and said something witty back to him, like, you gotta hold on to that thing or something.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, I remember. Yeah,
let me look that up.
I do remember he commented on there.
That's a funny bug. We need to get Jake out on here.
Well, yeah.
I'd love to hear him talk.
Man. Me too. That Jake Finley, man, he is a good egg.
He is.
He's such a good guy.
Yeah. He needs to marry that Janie.
All right, let's see.
Where it should be on there.
Oh, yeah. Stroke by Tony? Is that
Stroking Tony.
Stroking Tony? Is that... Okay, let me just... we're just going to have some fun, all right, guys?
He hashtagged it.
What did it say?
What's it say, Ming?
It says stroke by Tony.
Stroke by Tony.
So what does that mean again?
So that horse is Stroking Tony. That's its name. So he's saying stroked by Tony.
The fun, there's actually a funnier comment on there. And Bronk Beer, one of Zeke's sponsors, and they come out with like an apparel line or something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it's got like Bronk Beer or whatever, and he's holding, he's got one of his cheesy ass quotes on it, and it's like, you can't buck this shirt off. And Jake Finley comments, a bit Stroking Tony good. Oh man. Yeah. It's that one. That you Jake. Should scroll up and show it.
That Jake.
It's the one in that white shirt right there.
Yeah, here it is. You can't buck this shirt off.
And who replied to it? Oh, he deleted it.
Jake Finley. No, Jake. I bet it's on there.
Oh, right there. I bet. I bet Stroking Tony would buck it off your back.
That Jake Finley, he's so funny, man. He's so witty.
He is.
That's awesome.
And he's fast with it, man.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, he's pretty sharp.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to be at the losing end of a bickering match with him.
Yeah, definitely not.
No, it's pretty funny.
Well, I'm going to take a quickly. You guys go ahead and keep continuing. We'll talk about...
talk about your injury this year, Lefty.
Injury? Well, kind of a bad deal. So I was in Kennewick, Washington. We went over this in the last podcast, but I blew my knee out, tore my PCL and partial tear of my LCL. So I was 12th in the world when that happened, and it put me back to, ended up 17th. I missed the last month in, I think, 6 days of the last season, which is hard. Dawson was kind of in the same boat last year. Me and Dawson are kind of been going back and forth the last 3 years. He made the NFR in 19, and then I got hurt in 19. And then last year when I made the NFR, he had a big head injury. He didn't make it either. So we've been kind of going back and forth battling that. But next year we're both going to be there. It's going to be a pretty sweet moment because we've been waiting a while for it.
Yeah, I hope it's not my turn next year. No, again. It won't. But no, it's a tough deal coming out from an injury and watching. I mean, is sitting on the side and watching people go past you, especially when you're that close. It's tough, but it's something that comes with the sport.
It is. It's painful. It's painful to see, but at the end of the day, you know, it's rodeo. It's what we do for a living, and it's part of it. You know, you can't sit there and be bitter. Me and Dawson had a big talk about this earlier, actually. You can't sit there and be bitter about making excuses. You know, you can make excuses, but realistically, I could have had a better winter. I could have won a lot more money in the winter, and I could have been at the NFR. You know, the injury is not the reason I'm not at the NFR. Mm-hmm. And that's one thing that makes me mad. You know, sometimes I'll
be, it's an easy excuse to use.
It is. It like, is a very easy.
Last year I ended up, I think I finished out 17th or something. Yeah. Same boat as you, sort of. And you know, for a while there I was sitting there thinking, you know, I got hurt last year, this is the reason I didn't make the finals. I did have to take a lot of time off, 3 months off, but like I said, the month that I was rodeoing, I was sitting coming in out of the winter run, you know, 9th or 10th in the world, and I did terrible up until I got hurt. I got on some pretty good horses, and I could have been at a point where I had the finals made before I got injured. Yeah. That would have been.
And people will be like, oh, I'm sorry, you know, I'm sorry you got hurt, and it's like, Don't be sorry, you know, like it's my fault, and I take total responsibility. I wasn't riding my full potential all winter, but
I think you learned a lot this year though about entering. Like you got stuffed in with too many rodeos right off the bat, and like going into next year, I think you got a way better game plan.
Oh yeah, you know, you live and you learn out here. The same built. We're 22 years old, you know, you live and you learn. You don't got everything figured out, just like anything in life. You know, look at Kobe Bryant, look at any Tiger Woods, you know, they're not gonna be, you live and you learn, and that's the beauty of rodeo. You're never gonna completely have it figured out and all that stuff, but you could damn sure get better every opportunity you get. But
You sure hope so.
Yeah.
So, you know, with that being said, guys, we're going to wrap it up. It's been a great, great, great podcast. If you guys know the deal, we want you guys to like, subscribe, tell a friend, hit that notification bar so you guys know when the next episode is coming up. I'm Meng Lee from Make Lion Productions. This is
Dawson Hay
and Lefty Holman. Welcome to the show, everybody. Like, subscribe, guys. We're going to be coming out with some merchandise here hopefully soon. So get them subscribes going so we
can get there, guys.
Yeah, we enjoy doing this and it's fun. And I think everything I've been hearing, everybody's enjoying it too. So keep it rolling. We're having a good time out here.
All right. We'll see you guys in the next podcast, guys. Thank you guys again for watching.
Peace.
Awesome.